Hey there, friends, Carly here. Today I thought I would just pop on really quick and do a little flip through of the Traveler's Notebook I created for PlannerCon, which is coming up in just a couple of short weeks. Last year I put together this planner and I had my ticket in there, my itinerary, the classes I was taking, my packing lists, all kinds of things in here. And if you want to check out a video, a flip through of this, I will post that in the description box below. So this is the little traveler's notebook I'm putting together this year, and right now it's a work in progress because when I get home I'll be adding photos, any other little memorabilia that I pick up along the way. But I purchased this little traveler's notebook at Hobby Lobby at their 75% off sale, and I recovered it to some paper that I also bought at the sale and added washi tape and all these cute little die cuts that I got through the Planner Society kits. Inside, I just used some cute stickers that I already had in my stash. This one is the Golden Gate Bridge. And then I've just printed this off from online. I found this, I think on their, I can't remember if it was on their website or somewhere I found the little PlannerCon logo. And so I printed that off. And then this is just scrapbook paper. Like I said, this is kind of a work in progress. So I've got spaces that I left open that I can journal or put photos. I also would like to get creative and do some little tip-ins and things like that. I'm hoping to take the Carpe Diem Traveler's Notebook class, and they said they were going to share a bunch of cool ideas in that class too. On this page, I'm going to put my packing list, so I will be filling this out before I go. I'm just trying to figure out what I want to take this year. On this page, I put my PlannerCon ticket, and then I'm also going to put my itinerary on this page. Some pages in the book I did pre-decorate so I can add photos or journal on them. So this page I thought was so cute. I love this little sticker I got from my Agenda 52 book from Hobby Lobby. And I thought she was so cute. So she kind of looks like she has a little shopping bag, so I could use this for a shopping page. Or maybe I'll use it for pictures from the Planathon that's on Saturday night. This page I created for the Night of Stars, which is on Friday night. And I love all these cute little lights and these little lanterns I thought were so adorable. So I left plenty of room so I can journal or add photos. This page is going to be my shopping list. So on here, I'm going to put the special things that I'm looking for at the vendors because I tend to get a little bit overwhelmed when I see all of these wonderful things that you can buy. So I'm going to have a shopping list so I remember what I'm, you know, specialty items that I'm actually looking for. And then, of course, anything else that looks good, hopefully I can purchase those as well. This page I created for some of the shopping vendors that I particularly love, so I can remember to go back and visit their sites online, whether they have like Etsy stores or, you know, a website that I can go, you know, read their blogs or whatever. I just thought I would have a page that's kind of open-ended. So anything to do with shopping, whether it's maybe coupon codes that we get that we can use after PlannerCon, or just favorite shops or business cards, whatever I want to put on this page, I just kind of left this open. I love this cute little die cut. This was from Planner Society, and this cute little ring planner is from The Reset Girl. I love the font of these stamps. These are from Concord and Ninth. This is another page I decorated. I'm not sure what I'll put on here, but maybe either shopping, more shopping information, or just pictures or journaling. This page as well. These stickers are from The Reset Girl. This page is in the middle of the book. So my plan was to put some sort of like a tab either on the top or the side so I can find it really quick. And I was planning to put my schedule because that really helped a lot last year. Let me show you. I did like a schedule. I just kind of made it on like Pages or Word program. And I just put like, you know, when the speakers were speaking, when I had open times to shop, what classes I was taking, what room they were in. So this kind of helped me just sort of navigate the day. You do get like an 8 by 8.5 by 11, you know, big packet of sheets in your registration packet. However, it's kind of a lot to carry around, and then it listed all of the classes and all the speakers. And so it was really handy to kind of have my own personalized schedule so I could see exactly where I was going to go for each class or speaker. So I'm planning to do something similar this year. I'll either do it on the computer or I'll just write it out, but I'm kind of waiting until they get the final like daily schedule or agenda planned out, and then also to find out which classes I'm able to take. And then I did sort of want to leave a spot or a page open for each of the different speakers and panels. So this one is for Christy Dickerson, and I'm planning to maybe do their names down the side. I haven't really figured that out yet. I wanted to see, you know, how many notes I take during class, and then I'll kind of decorate around that. So this is Brian Taylor, another speaker. This is one of the panels that we'll be having. This is Sweet Stamp Shop. I'm also hoping I get into their class. This is Amy Tangerine. She was really great last year, so I'm excited to hear her speak again this year. This one is for the Sunday panel. And then here's just an open sheet. So also if I go sightseeing, I can also add my pictures in here. Or if I just have some creative time, I thought that would be cute because I have the little create stickers. Those are also from the Reset Girl. Here is a little notes page that I made. This is actually a post-it note from the Planner Society, and I just added some stickers. And this page is another blank page. I wanted to leave a certain number of pages just sort of open-ended so I can kind of add whatever. Last year when I journaled, I did some pages in here and I just sort of had them all together so I could staple them at the end of my trip and kind of put together a little booklet. So this year I decided I'll kind of just have things kind of open-ended and kind of pages that are blank interspersed with all the decorating so I can just kind of journal anywhere, add pictures. So I'm excited to see how this little notebook works out for me at PlannerCon and how it kind of evolves as I'm journaling and decorating while I'm there and then adding the photos when I get home. This page I left just blank with some cute scrapbook paper, and then this is also blank so I could add photos there as well. I'm excited to see how this turns out. I'm going to use this for my Traveler's Notebook cover. I got this a long time ago. I did a haul video. I think this was called the Tropical Life Collection at Michael's, and it doesn't have pockets in the little Traveler's Notebook cover, but I did buy this at the same time that I got the cover. I bought this little insert from Webster's Pages. So I'm planning to keep my book inside this little cover, and then I have this spot for either stickers or contact cards or whatever little bits and bobs I pick up along the way. But if you want to see the haul of when I purchased this and the other things that I bought at the same time, I can also link that video for you below. And I have this cute little charm that I also got at Michael's. I love these little fuzzy charms. I think they're so cute. So anyway, thanks so much for spending time with me today. If you're planning on going to PlannerCon, please let me know in the comments below. I'd love to meet you and hang out. Until next time, have a great week, friends. Bye.